Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. begins his pitch for the Maharlika Investment Fund. Marcos mentioned the controversial fund during his speech at the World Economic Forum's Country Strategy Dialogue on Tuesday. This even as the fund has yet to be established, with the measure only hurdling the House of Representatives, while a counterpart bill has not been filed at the Senate yet.
The process of establishing our first ever sovereign wealth fund is underway. Such a fund is one tool among many in our efforts to diversify our financial portfolio, which includes our existing institutions pursuing investment that will generate stable returns, but also welfare effects spanning employment creation, improvement of public service, and a decrease in costs of economic activities.
President Marcos also highlighted the Philippines economy's ability to withstand external shocks.
Our strong macroeconomic fundamentals, fiscal discipline, structural reforms, and liberalization of key sectors instituted over the years have enabled us to withstand the negative shocks caused by the pandemic and succeeding economic downturns and map a route towards a strong recovery. There's a vast range of investment opportunities available, such as in renewable energy, agro-processing, transportation, infrastructure development, amongst others, and several public-private partnerships in the pipeline.
The lead convener of the Private Sector Advisory Council highlighting the strong partnership between the Marcos administration and the private sector. Sabine Aboitiz says Marcos is on the right track in terms of nation building. He adds the president is also effectively showcasing the Philippines on the global stage.
President's belief in the private sector is very strong. You know, the amount of money we need is quite a large sum for the country to build the infrastructure projects that we want, between the roads, the ports, you know, the airports. So we're going to need a lot of the funds to come in. So we're going to need a lot of the funds and the expertise from countries around the world. Right? And so for us, the private sector, we can partner with the best in the world, right, to be able to solve problems, and not band-aid, but to structurally change so that it works for the generations to come.
Top business leaders from Europe and Asia impressed with transport projects in the Philippines. That statement coming from Transport Chief Jimmy Bautista after holding meetings at the sidelines of the World Economic Forum.
Impressed sila, no? Especially yung kagabi makausap namin when we told them that our economy is growing at the rate of 6.5 to 7%. No? Me personally, I was able to share with Mr. Tony Blair, no, the projects of the Department of Transportation. No? And he was very interested in supporting especially the railway projects of the government.
This despite the air traffic mess that happened on New Year's due to the bogging down of air navigation system. Philippine Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual, meanwhile, also meeting with business executives as he hopes to bring in more investors to help the country's pandemic recovery. Mr. Pascual touted recent economic policy reforms, which he claims improve the ease of doing business in the country. The Philippines' top economic agency on Tuesday said engaging the private sector is one of the top agenda of the government.
When we weathered this COVID-19 pandemic, at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, nakita natin yung pakikipagtulungan ng private sector sa pamahalaan, yung mga LGUs din, also coordinated with their own private sector.